And a little luck that time, but it drops.
Well, I'm not sure how that one found the bottom of the net, but hey, you take it when it comes.
And finished off by Brown.
Boy, it's so much fun seeing Brown drop the hammer. Just an amazing dunker who bashes the basket.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Morris, no good.
Boy, they dodged one there, guys. I mean, he got the wide open look that he wanted, just didn't knock it down.
Offensive rebound. Back to Brown. And it's off the back rim, no good. And we have an intentional foul there, G.A. Wish I could say why.
That one's pretty strange. I mean, no idea what got into his head right there.
Boy, it was a bumpy start to his career for Michael Porter. I mean, this guy had his entire rookie season taken away because of back surgery and had a big mountain to climb just to get back out on the court. But, you know, to his credit, he made the climb.
And, oh, it's the buzzer beater!
One eye on the rim, one eye on the clock. Nice job.
What was really impressive there, though, guys, was that he could have...
The scoring fast and furious as we end the first quarter. Denver on top, up 6. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. What do you guys think about the Nuggets out here in this one?
Yeah, in that first period, they look to push in transition at every opportunity.
Yeah, I like the way they play. They're looking to get up and down the court every time. Racehorse basketball here tonight. Strap it up. Don't look down. You'll miss something.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, if you can believe it, before Jaylen Brown went to the draft, one executive said the Cal Berkeley star was too smart. Brown says when athletes are also informative, it can intimidate. You get pushback from outside interests. The whole shut up and dribble movement is big, and I'm a part of that movement. Guys.
Strong story, D.A. there. Thanks. It's stolen by Morris. They're running. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Nuggets.
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots. A key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
They also came out of the locker room with their running shoes on. I mean, their transition game has been full throttle.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And there's the foul against Denver. Austin shooting the first shots from the stripe in this game. Greg, you really began to emerge and got on the national scene at UNLV, but you started your college career at Portland where you were actually named the Conference Freshman of the Year.
Yeah, how about I actually averaged more points in Portland than in any season I played at Vegas. Totally different roles, but Portland's always going to have a sweet spot in my heart. My first child was born in the great city of Portland.
And the officials call him for a 3-second violation. Denver making a switch here. And Denver has possession. 6-point game. Morris into the lane. Deep 2 for Murray. They get it back. Here's Jokic. That one goes in. Jokic has got 10 points.
Persistence pays, and Jokic not giving up on the play, doing a nice job pursuing the basketball there.
Pass to Pritchard. Back to Green. Now here's Thompson. It's hauled in by Jokic. Well, we know, Greg, that Jokic is such a unique talent at that center position. Young player, already top 10 in career triple-doubles.
How about the most triple-doubles ever by a foreign player? You think of the great skilled European big man. Jokic, arguably the most skilled of them all.
We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter.